So today, our lighter topic, which includes, we'll have some networking as well and kind of see how this plays out for you. Our topic is around the five languages of appreciation. So for several years, we've been teaching classes based on the work of Paul White, and his work is based on his relationship and the work of Gary Chapman. So Gary Chapman years ago wrote a book called The Five Love Languages and produced a whole bunch of wonderful resources and materials around the five love languages. And he and Paul White got together and realized that, you know, at workplace, we don't say love, right? We don't say love at work. We can talk about our feelings sometimes after about 2006. But other than that, we weren't even allowed to talk about our feelings. And we certainly don't call them love languages in the workplace. So they created a text called Languages of Appreciation in the Workplace. And we've been teaching this for several years. And it's stuff that if you're not familiar with it, it will resonate immediately as easy to grasp and easy to understand. But even if you are familiar with it, this is a great moment to stop and think about these languages of appreciation or the love languages. There are five of them. And the five basic languages, when they're introduced, are usually introduced in the order of frequency. So like the most common is at the top and the least common is towards the bottom. And we're going to talk about them just a second and talk about what that means for you in the workplace if you're working from home, and what it means for you for your weekend if you're staying at home and you've already been there for several days. So the first one is words of affirmation. This is really that desire for specific words that are genuine and that are connected to a person in appreciation of who that person is and the value they're bringing to the table. The vast majority of us speak this as one of our languages, if not our primary language. The second one is acts of service. So these are people who love it when you help them fold the laundry. These are people who love it when you carry something to them rather than, you know, say, hey, come and pick this up whenever you're ready. These are people who speak the language of service, and they value that. The third language is quality time, and these are people who enjoy being with someone else. So quality time, the way you express appreciation to someone who speaks quality time is you look them in the eye and you spend time with them. These are people who are constantly looking for ways for us to connect, right? So quality time is important. And then receiving gifts, there are people who speak that language of receiving gifts where the fact that someone else has thought of them and has made an effort to identify and purchase or make or contribute a gift that is meaningful to them and that connects with them, that's a language that they speak. And then the last one, perhaps the least common, but definitely should not be overlooked, is the language of physical touch. So these are the people who, when you interact with them, they stand closer than others. They're the ones who reach out for that high five or go all the way in for the hug. These are the people who very often are very expressive with their bodies as well. And they speak a language that says if no one touches them, if no one hugs them, and in this case, we're really talking, you know, safe touches, shoulders, and, you know, the top third of the arm and those kinds of things. But those, though, if no one touches them and someone values or speaks this language as their primary language, they begin to feel undervalued and unappreciated and really, really lonely and withdrawn. And so I wanted to just toss those out there. Hopefully you're familiar with those five, and we'll have a recap of the five. But right now, as you think about those and as you consider those, for your colleagues, right now, for your colleagues, engage in the languages of appreciation as a discussion point with your colleagues. Use it as one of those coffee talk things. Use it as a chance to connect with others and say, you know, here's what's your language of appreciation, or I think it's this, and here's what mine is, or hey, have we checked out some of those resources that are available? Have we looked at it? Let's talk about it together. And at home, do the same thing. If you're not immediately aware of the language of appreciation spoken by the people who live with you right now, if you're like, this is totally foreign and I don't know, use this as one of those many conversations that you're going to get to have. Use this as a reason to talk about anything other than coronavirus, right? Right now, you can change your topic of conversation with this. You can ask someone, what's your language of appreciation? And or what's your love language, and share yours, and you can engage in the discussion. We have some resources available on our site, and we'll share those in our follow-up as well, additional tools that you can use on that. And then, so once you've engaged in the conversation with your colleagues, perhaps yet today or on Monday, and for the people that you're living with or that you're trapped, perhaps your loved ones, maybe the ones who you do love and are not near to you, engaging in that conversation is still super important. So I invite you to engage that conversation, and then go out of your way. Go out of your way to do something that connects with them in their language. It is so much more uplifting for us as humans when we stop and stop thinking about ourselves and what we need. And I assure you, we're all thinking about what we need right now. But if you can, we can shift our focus off of ourselves and think about the other people that we interact with and what they need, and turn our interactions to give that other person what they need and build them up, they in turn will feel lifted. They'll be able to inspire and connect with others. They will give back in tenfold, right? As we give out, we will get those same things back to us. So I invite you to just really be one of the helpers right now and go the extra mile for the language of appreciation.